हरे कृष्णा। कुंती वाच स्विफ्ट टेक्स्ट। नम पंकज नभाय नभ पंकज मालिने नम पंकज नेत्राय नमस्ते पंकज आग्रहे। माई रिस्पेक्टफुल ऑब्लिगेशंस आर अनटू यू अ लॉर्ड हुज एब्डोमेन इज मार्क विद अ डिप्रेशन लाइक अ लोटस फ्लावर, हु आर ऑलवेज डेकोरेटेड विद गार्लैंड्स ऑफ लोटस फ्लावर्स, हुज ग्लास इज एज कूल एज द लोटस एंड हुज फीट आर एनग्रेव्ड विद लोटसेस। नम पंकज नभाय नम पंकज मलिने नम पंकज नेत्राय नमस्ते पंकज अंग्रहे। श्रीमद भागवतम 1.8.22। Here are some of the specific symbolical marks on the spiritual body of the personality of Godhead which distinguishes his body from the bodies of all others. They are all special features of the body of the Lord. The Lord may always appear as one of us, but he is always distinct by his specific bodily features. Srimati Kunti claims herself unfit to see the Lord because of her being a woman. This is claimed because women, Shudras, the liberal class, and the Dvija Bandhus or the wretched descendants of the higher three classes are unfit by intelligence to understand transcendental subject matter concerning the spiritual name, fame, attributes, forms, etc. of the Supreme Absolute Truth. Such persons, although they are unfit to enter into the spiritual affairs of the Lord, can see him as the Archa Vigra who descends on the material world just to distribute favors to the fallen souls, including the above mentioned women, Shudras and Dvija Bandhus. Because such fallen souls cannot see anything beyond matter, the Lord condescends to enter into each and every one of the innumerable universes as the Garbhodakshayi Vishnu, who grows a lotus stem from the lotus-like depression in the center of his transcendental abdomen, and thus Brahma, the first living being in the universe, is born. Therefore, the Lord is known as Pankajanabhi. The Pankajanabhi Lord accepts the Archa Vigrahi's transcendental form in different elements, namely a form within the mind, a form made of wood, a form made of earth, a form made of metal, a form made of jewels, a form made of paint, a form made of sand, etc. All such forms of the Lord are always decorated with garlands of lotus flowers, and there should be a soothing atmosphere in the temple of worship to attract the burning attention of the non-devotees always engaged in material wranglings. The mediators worship a form within the mind. Therefore, the Lord is merciful even to the women, Shudras and Dvij Bandhus, provided they agree to visit the temple and worship the different forms made for them. Such temple visitors are not idolaters, as alleged by some men with a poor fund of knowledge. All the great acharyas established such temples of worship in all places just to favor the less intelligent and one should not pose himself as transcending the stage of temple worship while one is actually in the category of the Shudras and the women or less. One should begin to see the Lord from his lotus feet, gradually rising to the thighs, waist, chest and face. One should not try to look at the face of the Lord without being accustomed to seeing the lotus feet of the Lord. Srimati Kunti, because of her being the aunt of the Lord, did not begin to see the Lord from the lotus feet because the Lord might feel ashamed. And thus Kunti Devi, just to save a painful situation for the Lord, began to see the Lord just above his lotus feet, that is from the waist of the Lord, gradually rising to the face and then down to the lotus feet. In the round, everything there is in order. If one sees the lotus flower, one can immediately remember Krishna. For example, if one loves one's child and one sees any one of the child's garments or his shoes or a small sheep or any of his playthings, one will immediately remember the child. Oh, these are my child's shoes. These are my child's playthings. This is his garment. This is the nature of love. So if one actually loves God, Krishna, one can remember him always. It is not difficult to remember Krishna. Here, Kunti Devi describes Krishna with reference to lotus flowers. Similarly, when Krishna describes himself in Bhagavad Gita, he says, Raso aham apsu kaunteya, I am the taste of liquids. So one can remember Krishna by tasting water. If one is drinking liquor, if he thinks the taste of this drink is Krishna, he will one day turn out to be a great saintly person. So I can request even drunkards to become Krishna conscious, what to speak of others, because Krishna says, Raso aham apsu kaunteya. I am the taste of liquids. Generally, in this context, liquid is taken to mean water, but liquor is also liquid. It is only sugar and molasses or some other combination fermented and distilled. Of course, it is bad because it creates intoxication. Although in one sense nothing is bad, liquor is bad because it creates bad effects. In America, there are many drunkards. There is no scarcity of them, but I may request even the drunkards, when drinking wine, kindly remember that the taste of this drink is Krishna. Just begin in this way and one day you will become a saintly Krishna conscious person. So Krishna is available under any circumstances if you want to catch him. कृष्ण सेज इन भगवद गीता 10.10 तेषां सतत युक्तानां भजतां प्रीतिपूर्वकं ददामि बुद्धि योगं ते येन माम उपयन्ति ते. टू दोज हु आर कॉन्स्टेंटली डिवोटेड एंड हु वर्शिप मी विथ लव आई गिव द अंडरस्टैंडिंग बाय विच दे कैन कम टू मी. इफ वन इज एक्चुअली वेरी सीरियस इन सर्चिंग फॉर कृष्ण, कृष्ण इज एवरीवेयर. अंधांतरस्थ परमाणु चयंतरस्थम गोविंदम आदिपुरुषम तमहं भजामि. ब्रह्म संहिता 5.35. Krishna is present within the universe, within our hearts, and even within the atom. So it is not difficult to find him, but one must know the process by which to do so. This process is very simple, and by the order of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we are distributing this process to everyone without charge. The process is to chant Hare Krishna. As soon as one chants Hare Krishna, one will immediately understand Krishna. Similarly, simply by hearing or chanting the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam, one can be purified. Whatever knowledge exists in the world is present in Srimad Bhagavatam. It includes literature, poetry, astronomy, philosophy, religion, and love of Godhead. Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam. If one simply reads Srimad Bhagavatam, he gains the topmost education. For if one studies Srimad Bhagavatam, he'll be well versed in every subject matter. Even if one does not understand a single word of the mantras of Srimad Bhagavatam, the vibrations themselves have such power that simply by chanting one will be purified. Shranvatam Svakatha Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana. The word punya means pious, shravana means hearing, and kirtana means chanting. One who chants or hears the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam becomes pious automatically. To become pious, one generally has to endeavor a great deal. But if one simply hears the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita, one becomes pious automatically. Therefore, it is a requisite principle in every temple of our Krishna consciousness movement that there must be a daily class for hearing and chanting. Our movement is meant for training spiritual leaders, but without hearing and chanting, it is impossible to become a leader. Of course, in the material world it is possible, but not in the spiritual world. In Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila 19.152 it is said, Malihana se bijakarya rupana shravana kirtana jale karaye sachana. Hearing and chanting waters the spirit of devotional service, which develops one's original consciousness. So here in this prayers, Kunti Devi, a great devotee, is giving us an opportunity to become Krishna conscious simply by concentrating our mind on Pankaja, the lotus flower. Panka means mud and ja means generate. Although the lotus flower is generated from mud, it is a most important flower and Krishna likes it very much. Kunti Devi therefore describes all the parts of Krishna's body with reference to lotus flowers, so that as soon as one sees a lotus flower, one will immediately think of Krishna. Oh, Krishna's navel is just like a lotus, and from Krishna's navel grew the stem of the lotus upon which Brahma, the creator of this universe, was born. This universe includes so many planets, seas, mountains and cities with motor cars and other paraphernalia, but the entire universe began from that lotus. Nama Pankajamaline. From Krishna comes the wonderful lotus flower that contains the seed of the entire universe, but is not the source of only one such flower. Krishna is not so poor that he simply produces one lotus flower and then is finished. No, as there may be a garland with many flowers, Krishna is the source of innumerable universes, which may be compared to a big garland of lotuses. This is God. Yaseka Nisheshveta Kalam Athavalambya Jivanti Loma Vilaja Jagad Andanatha. Brahma Samhita 5.48. Krishna is unlimited. We are very much concerned with this one planet, but Krishna's creation contains an unlimited number of planets. We cannot count how many planets there are, any more than one can count how many hairs there are on one's head. This is the nature of Krishna's creation. To give another example, on one tree there is an unlimited number of leaves. Similarly, there is an unlimited number of planets and there are unlimited universes. Therefore, Krishna is unlimited. Krishna's level resembles a lotus. He is garlanded with lotuses, and his eyes are also compared to the petals of a lotus. Alola Chandra Kalasada Vanamalaya Vamsi. Brahma Sahita 5.31. So, if we simply think of only this one verse which describes Krishna's body with reference to the lotus, we can meditate our whole life on how beautiful Krishna is, how wise Krishna is, and how Krishna manifests his creation. This is meditation, thinking of Krishna. ध्यानवस्थिता तदगतेन मनस पश्यन्ति यम योगिनः. A yogi is one who always thinks of Krishna. Those who think of something impersonal are not yogis. Their meditation simply involves undergoing more and more labor. Klesho adhikatarastesham avyaktashaktachetasam. And they cannot reach anything substantial. Therefore, after meditation, they say, come on, give me a cigarette. Come on, my throat is now dry. Give me a cigarette. That is not meditation. Meditation means thinking of Krishna always. Satatam chintayanto ma. एंड एंडेवरिंग टू एडवांस इन कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस विथ अ फर्म व्यू यतंतश्च द्रध व्रतः वी हैव टू बी प्यूरिफाइड परम ब्रह्म परम धाम पवित्रम परमम भवन Because Krishna is pure, we cannot approach Krishna impurely. But if we think of Krishna always and meditate upon Krishna, then we shall be purified. Punya Shravana Kirtanam. That meditation can be possible by hearing and chanting, and then thinking of Krishna will automatically come. That is the process of Krishna consciousness. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smarnam. The word Smarnam means remembering. If we chant and hear, then remembrance will automatically come, and then we shall engage in worshipping Krishna's lotus feet, Sevanam. Then we shall engage in temple worship, archanam, and offering prayers, vandanam. We shall engage ourselves as Krishna's servants, dasyam. We shall become Krishna's friend, sakyam, and we shall surrender everything to Krishna, atmanivedanam. This is the process of Krishna consciousness. So, let us see what Kunti Devi says. Namah Pankaja Nabhaya, Namah Pankaja Maline, Namah Pankaja Netraya, Namaste Pankaja Angrahe. My respectful obeisances are unto you, O Lord, whose abdomen is marked with a depression like a lotus flower, who are always decorated with garlands of lotus flowers, whose glass is as cool as the lotus, and whose feet are engraved with lotuses. Namah Pankaja Nabhaya, Namah Pankaja Maline, Namah Pankaja Netraya, Namaste Pankaja Angrahe. Hare Krishna, we'll continue further tomorrow. Hari Bol.